Right, gonna have a go at putting together my abba stand. Got delivery of it today. Really quite chuffed with it. So here's the bike, package 2, fully unpacked, just 2 items. Main center stand with the bottom bit there ready for to receive the legs and wheels, I suppose. And there's the bit that runs up and down via the hydraulic jack. And box number 3. So it looks like the 3 legs and part of the actual bike support for once it's on the jack, red one there. So 3 legs ready to receive some wheels. Let's see if we can't find the instructions. Right, back again. This is the remainder of the first box. So basically I've unwrapped it all now. Any of you who've got one of the abba superbike stands will recognize this. It's very similar.
In with that lot was
so
this back again ram. Done, apparently
managed to get the wheels on now, so pretty straightforward job. Make sure you follow these instructions here. They're 1 of 2 instructions. Put a bit on that so you can see that, purely for fitting the wheels. 1 of 2, you can see their top left hand corner. They get you to fit this one first. Make sure you do the right wheel, the one with the brake. That bit there. Oops, there. On the main upright. And then, one by one, get these 3 on without the brake. So basically you've got 1 brake for the stand on the centre part. These things are colour coded. You can see that there on the tip, and they tell you which one goes where, which wheel goes on what, depending on the colour. Right, back again onto the next phase of this assembly. Just unpacked some more bits and pieces from the packaging. Just moving a bit closer, we've got the strap there, like I said before, that's for the strapping the rear end of the bike down, which will then lift the front as you jack the bike up. That's obviously for the ram to place into the sliding rail so that the hydraulics aren't taking all of the weight. That's obviously the bobbin that fits into the mainstay so that the strap can attach to the stand itself. A couple of bolts, 2 different sizes, so beware. 3 nuts and different washers. Yeah, to establish what the 3 are for, if I'm honest. Some nice little fixings there for Allen key fixings. That looks like it's the plastic stopper goes on top of the main stand. And these look like a couple of runners which are probably going to fix to, I don't know, maybe that little beauty there or something. I don't know, we'll see in a bit. And that's the buckle for the strap. You've got it, you take note, and if you tighten it right up, then untighten it by 1/4 of a turn, so it's got some slack bit of movement for the ram. So this one's the big bolt of the 2 from the pack. Again, didn't have big enough spanner, so I had to use the grips and my other spanner there. Forgot the name for it for a minute. Make sure the sleeves go on, yeah, and make sure they turn. I.e. not too tight, clamped together. We don't want it clamped together too tight. One thing just to remember, this little thumb screw here, I don't know if you can see it, just point to it. That one. If you've not operated a hydraulic jack before, turn it clockwise or pretty much to the strap position, and then you can pump up, because you need to do that in order to get these in line so you can get that bolt through there. Okay, so you get them in line with the holes on the sides here through the ram, making sure these sleeves are threaded on as you go through that side and that side. Make sure your washers are on, like I say, make sure it's not too tight. So yeah, you give you this little handle, pump up and down. There we go, bit of a walk around. So a bit of progress. The red L-shaped thing there coming out of the gold centerpiece is the main lifting apparatus. So basically all I've done is stuck a bolt through there, lined it up, made sure that the roller down here, that's the bit that obviously goes up and down against the central post, the black post, so make sure that's lined up before you tighten up here. Don't over tighten it, make sure there's a bit of slack, but reasonably tight. There's a lock in that anyway, so it's not a problem if you, you know, it's not going to come off anyway. So one other thing they tell you to do if you intend to lift your bike, first of all in the horizontal position, is to put this little bobbin thing into the red bar. That red bar eventually will slide into there, and obviously then that will extend out to swinging arm length, where it will then be just underneath the bobbin, which we'll fix later on. That's still in its packet over there, and that's all kind of strapped down in the horizontal position, making sure your bike stays there by that there.
Right, back again. So finish the assembly, everything's attached, all tightened, checked all the nuts for the right tightening, because at the end of the day this is going to be lifting my beautiful bike at height, and I'm going to be putting a lot of trust in it. So I suppose a couple of things to watch out for include this little thing here. Now then, because you're going to be effectively lifting the bike from the left hand side of the bike, this is the insert that will go into the left. Now then, you'll notice there's a difference. This one here has just a single solid shape protrusion there. That's the one that goes into the main stand. And then this one here has a stepped insert that goes in to the other side. Now obviously I've got a Kawasaki ZZR, so that's the case for mine, may not be the case with yours. And the reason for that is this is the swinging arm pivot. You stick your finger in there and you'll feel the recess, so that's designed to go into there, a nice snug fit. And on the other side it doesn't have that little reduction in there, it's straight through, hence the reason for using the other insert. So I'm just trying to finish off reading the instructions, a little bit confused about the double buckle that they've put onto the strap. Not come across that before. Basically it's this one here, there's the strap, there's the buckle. So I'm just fathoming that out, giving myself a bit of time. And then they've given you this thing here as well, so it's obviously a safety thing. I'm just trying to work out how that works before I attempt to lift the old machine up high level. So effectively then, you'll see this in a bit, I'll continue this video. It may even be brave enough to show you the bike lifted. This one here will eventually go on to, I don't know if you can see that there, cameraman am I, but that goes on to there once the bike is in that position. So just move away from that so you can see it, getting older. So there you can see where the two pins either side go into the swing arm pivot on both sides of the bike, effectively creating a bit of a cradle there and a pivot point for the bike, which then obviously allows you to lift it in the three positions using the strap, which I've got to suss out yet. So how are you doing? There it is, up off the ground.
There's the proof. Sorted out the tricky bit there. I'll maybe go through that for you a little bit. Found it a little bit tricky, but when you look back, it's pretty straightforward. It's just getting used to it for the first time, how to assemble that strap, that is. Obviously in the horizontal position, so I've got this extending bar using the bobbin and the swinging arm bobbin. Front wheel one off the ground. So
only partial up. I haven't put the pin in yet, but I will do in a bit. Took it very steady, making sure the brakes were on these things here on the wheels. Two brakes there and there. Stopped, making sure the levers are pressed firmly down and clipped down. So there it is. My little abba stand, £461 I think delivered. Face value, really quite pleased with it.
Yeah.
Cool. Now then, if you're like me, when you first see this thing, I spotted it on YouTube, this abba SkyLift. I thought, oh well, no, don't look very strong to me, but I'll tell you now, the gauge of the steel is really quite substantial. Nuts and bolts are obviously decent quality. The wheels are double wheeled on each one, so you know, all adds extra strength and stability. So yeah, I think I'm really quite pleased with that.
When he was 25, speed jive, don't wanna stay alive when you're 25. And when he's stealing clothes from Marks and Sparks, and Freddy's got spots from ripping off the stars from his face, funky little boat race. The television man is crazy, same with juvenile delinquent Rex. Oh man, I need TV. Stones, we never got it off on that revolution stove. What a drag! Too many snacks. Nah, I drunk a lot of wine and I'm feeling fine.